The bacteria that live inside you shape who you are on a pretty fundamental level, from your psychology to your body type. But new research also indicates that the billions and even trillions of tiny creatures in your body play a major role in the way you react to medical treatments, making your microbial ecosystem a literal matter of life and death. Yeah, hi, it's me, your favorite microbe geek here. As we discover more and more about how the bacteria inside us influence our lives and our health, we also discover more places where this relationship is really important. And one of those is cancer. Yeah, it turns out that your body's bacteria play a huge role in how you respond to cancer and its treatment. And they could hold the key to the future of how we treat this disease. In the last few decades, one promising way we've started treating cancer is called immunotherapy. It activates the body's own immune system to identify and attack cancerous cells. Scientists have been puzzled about why immunotherapy works so well in some patients, while in others it has little effect. And three recent studies indicate that it's likely the patient's bacterial populations that are the game changer. Researchers divided patient gut bacteria into the categories good and bad, and patients with more good bacteria were the ones who responded well to treatment with immunotherapy. Their tumors stopped growing or even shrank. Researchers then went on to demonstrate in mouse models that treating cancer patients with a cocktail of the good bacteria improved their response to the immunotherapy. The theory goes that our microbiome is intricately linked to our immune system. Bad bacteria seem to inhibit our immune system's proper functioning, while good bacteria help prep immune cells to be on the lookout for foreign bodies like tumors. And we're still unraveling exactly how all these relationships work. Immunotherapy is just the beginning. It's been demonstrated that bacteria can also be used directly to kill tumors. As in, you can inject bacteria into a tumor area and then watch as they grow to literally suffocate and starve that tumor because they're eating everything the tumor needs to grow. It's called bacteria-mediated tumor therapy, and it's surprisingly effective. But perhaps not so surprisingly, you do then have the problem of a potentially dangerous bacterial infection that you now need to treat. So balancing that is tricky and has hindered the progress and popularity of this treatment method. Bacteria also tend to produce something called a biofilm, which is one of my favorite bacterial behaviors. When there's a certain number of bacteria, called a quorum, they start to bind together, forming a mass of cells that behaves more like a single unit than like individual bacteria. Some research shows that biofilm formation actively disrupts and blocks tumor metastasis, suggesting it could be useful in stopping the spread of cancer while the patient goes through treatment. And it doesn't stop there. Bacteria can also be genetically engineered to detect cancer's movements. A probiotic form of E. coli, for example, can be taken by a patient whose subsequent urine output will then indicate whether their cancer has metastasized to their liver because of the way their body processed that bacteria. As living, breathing organisms themselves, bacteria are constantly producing lots of enzymes and proteins and hormone-like chemicals to communicate with each other, to help them eat stuff, to generally just live their little lives. Some bacteria produce toxins that help them kill whatever wants to eat them. And in some cases, this protein, called a bacteriocin, can be toxic to cancer cells. It can be used to aid the effect of certain cancer drugs, or on its own to tackle tumors in a huge variety of cancers. And even aside from being used directly, bacteria can be modified to carry targeted cancer treatment to the necessary tissues. But while our invisible microscopic friends can help us in the face of this disease, they can actively hinder us too. A seminal study revealed that in some patients who didn't respond well to chemotherapy, there were bacteria inside their tumors disabling those drugs to protect themselves, meaning the drugs couldn't do any damage against the tumor either. This discovery was actually a pretty huge revelation in our understanding of why some people's systems react to cancer treatment so differently. And it brings up the question, antibiotics or no? Obviously, we don't want bacteria that neutralize our cancer drugs, but can we get rid of those while also keeping the good bacteria that help our immune system? And not to mention the potential risk of accidentally creating cancer drug-killing bacteria that are then antibiotic resistant, which would be no bueno for anybody. This field is so exciting, and we're only just beginning to understand and take advantage of it. This basically opens up a whole new dimension in personalized medicine and could give us a much more detailed understanding of the diseases that plague us and how we treat them. Special thanks to our sponsor today, domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs from .club to .space to .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. If you think bacteria are as cool as I do, then check out my other video on how your gut microbes are controlling your mind. And fun fact, one of the most prevalent good bacteria that doctors found in patients who responded well to treatment is called Bifidobacterium longum. Good going, little guy. Make sure to keep coming back here for all things microscopically creepy crawly, and thanks for watching Seeker.